My name is Akufa Ijona. I'm 28 years old from Nigeria. I'm actually a student at Kaduna State University. My final year studying sociology. And I'm also the founder of Communication for Social Change, which is a media-based communication platform for young people to actually use the media, especially documentary films and photography, to use such tools as an advocacy tool and also educational tools that addresses community-specific concerns, which range from issues on women's participation in politics, HIV and AIDS, drug policies, gender-based violence, and all of it. Ever since 2002, after Kaleidoscope, myself and other young people formed this organization, which we've been working on really, really hard. In my village where I come from, like when we're having community meeting, the man speaks first. Like no matter how small the man is, he speaks before the woman. The women are always asked to speak when asked to. Like if we are making contribution, all the men will always speak first and later they say, okay, does any woman has anything to say? Like, so most of the time the power resides with women back home, but at the community level and otherwise. Yeah, when it comes to patriarchy in the society back home in Nigeria, it's very visible sometimes, and they are not visible other times because there are some norms, there are some values, there are some cultural beliefs that, okay, for example, if a woman is married, she's cut off the family in terms of inheritance, she doesn't get land, the family land, she can't get it because it's like, if you're getting that land, you're taking it to your husband's place. So that's this empowered woman, and it's at a disadvantage. Also, when it comes to political participation in politics, we always shout the CEDAW agreement in Nigeria. There are a lot of stuff that people are talking about, those agreements and those international treaties that say equal participation of women in politics. But the bottom line is that women still, they are seen at the political space, but they are not heard. And because you find out that, okay, women don't participate in politics because they don't have access to finance, they don't, their capacity are nowhere built. But myself, I'm looking at it from a point of view where I look forward to a society in Nigeria where women could have access to land, women could have access to loans and credits, where they could be financially independent or they are not necessarily depending on women, but they can actually fend for themselves and take care of themselves very well. And also, an ideal society for us would be where women could have the same opportunity to go to school and also decide if I want children or not, if I want to get married or not, because oftentimes there are instances where women are like sheep of the marriage at a very early age, and that kind of break the ability of going to school, because when immediately she's married, she's supposed to be having children, taking care of the children, taking care of the home, taking care of the husband also. So that puts her at a very disadvantaged position. So I'm looking at it where myself and other young people and anybody that cares for women would come together and actually advocate for equal treatment for women when it comes to access to land, credit, their participation in the political space, not just them voting, but they too also having seats in the parliament, in government, and in top ministries. So that I'm looking forward to that time, and I hope the time is now.